All right, this is rational expressions reducing, and we reduce just like we would in any normal fraction. So if we were to expand all this, we would just cancel. Cancel, 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 right? And then multiply what we have for our final answer, all right? So that's all we have to do with all these fractions is we're gonna reduce, that's 1 and that's 3. This C will take out one of those and give us C squared. So we have 1 times C squared times D squared over 3. And that would give us an answer of C squared D 5. I put squared. Let's change that back. D 5 over 3. And that's it. So as long as you have a fraction, and it's one fraction with all multiplication in between, we can reduce. So when we get to a problem like this, you can't cancel. This would be illegal. You cannot do that. What you have to do first is turn it into a multiplication. And the only way to do that is to factor. So we factor the top. Just write the bottom one in a parenthesis. And now we can cancel them off. And there's your answer. So let's try another one. This would be x plus 8. And this bottom one would be x. We know there has to be a plus 8, so we might as well start there. And then an x minus 2. And then we can cancel and write the answer. Now the x minus 2 has to go on the bottom, so we're putting a 1 on top. And where is that coming from is right here. Whenever you reduce two fractions, it's really a division, so we're getting a 1 top and bottom. And that 1 is just transferring. All right, here's a special one. So after I factored it, you notice they're not the same. So what we have to do is a little modification. So if you factor a negative out from the bottom, it switches it. So check it, negative times an x is a negative x. A negative times a minus 2 would be positive 2. It's still the same problem, but now we're allowed to cancel it. And what we get is x plus 2 over negative 1, which is really just negative x minus 2. All right? You're just dividing each one. So when they're opposites like this, you're basically factoring out a negative and canceling them. So another way to look at it is this. Let's try another one. When we cancel, all we ended up with was not a positive 1, but a negative 1. So when you cancel two that are exactly the same, it becomes 1 and 1. When you cancel two that are opposites, they become a negative 1. So you can just distribute that negative 1 now, which gives you negative x minus 3. So if they're opposites of each other, go ahead and cancel them, but just make sure you put a minus 1 in there. And make sure it is a multiply. And that's everything.
So if you flip the page now, you'll see there's a bunch of problems. Give these a shot, hit pause, and then when you unpause, the answers will appear. Okay, so hit pause now. All right, and there's your answers. You can hit pause and look at them. And those as well. And those are the final ones. Thank you.
Thank you.